Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and this is the Microsoft Surface Pro 6. The box doesn't say 6, just like last year, so maybe they decided to add that last minute, I'm not sure. And one of the things that's changed this year is it's updated processors. We've got 8th gen Intel Core i5 processors, they're quad core. This one has the 256 gigabyte option, which is the minimum you need in order to have the black color, and then also 8 gigabytes of RAM. Of course, it's expandable as well. Now, I've also got the Alcantara Signature Type Cover because the black one does not have Alcantara, and I really like that. I also picked up the pen, so we'll take a look at those in just a moment, but let's open the Surface first. So let's flip this over here. I've got it started right here. Let's remove this. Now, we're not going to see a whole lot of difference on the external parts of this, but let's open this up, take a look, and let's remove the top here. Opens really slowly, just like an Apple box, I guess now. There we go. And here's the Surface itself. Still very thin. We'll take a look at that in a moment. And in here, I believe we have the power plug, power adapter. So that's the wall part with the AC adapter. And then something that I really miss on Apple devices that they've kept on the Surface is the magnetic charging port cable. And so we've got this adapter, and we've also got an external USB, so if we need to charge something else, we can. So let me set that aside. And then let's take a look in here. We've got some literature and just one booklet, it looks like. So nothing else, no stickers or anything like that. Let's set this aside and take a look at the Surface. Let's open it up here. And like I said, this is the black model, which is a matte finish and looks really nice. Let's flip it over, and it looks pretty much the same as last time. And what we have is a 12.3-inch display, corner to corner, and it's also 2736 by 1824. It's a PixelSense display. They've always looked really good. And this one, there's something interesting as far as the options go with the processor. So, like I said, it's a Core i5, it's a quad core, and fanless this time around, just like last generation. The i7s have a fan, the i5s don't. So this time around, they've done something kind of interesting. It comes in at $899 for the very base model and goes all the way over $2,000, depending on which one you've got. Now, if you have the business model, you get a slightly higher clock speed. So depending on what you have, you might have a 1.6 gigahertz or a 1.7 gigahertz Core i5, without a fan, and the Core i7s have the fan. Now on the back, you can see we have our 8 megapixel camera with our microphones. And then on the back, of course, you've got the kickstand, and this folds up like this. And these are really durable, and this scares me every time I do this, but you can push this right flat and it doesn't hurt it at all. It bends no problem. And this also has expandable storage, which is something great. So if you've got 256 gigabytes of storage, just like this one, you need some more, you can put in another SD card and expand that storage. Now on the side, we take a look at the ports. We've got the Surface connector, of course, USB-A and DisplayPort. On the top, we've got our power and volume buttons. They've got a nice clicky feel to them, and it just turned on. And then on this side, we've got our headphone jack. And then on the front, we've got a forward-facing camera, 5 megapixel, and a microphone. So we'll wait for it to boot up. I'll set it down here, and let me grab the keyboard. So the keyboard here is, like I said, Alcantara. The black one doesn't have that, so if you want the Alcantara one, it's a little bit more, or you can find them usually pretty inexpensively at different places. You'll see it's ready to set up. I'll just hit the power button for now. Let's open up the keyboard quickly. Now these come in at about $150. However, I was able to get this on a deal from the local store here, Best Buy, for about $125. So it's less expensive. It's Alcantara, nice trackpad, backlit keyboard, and it protects your device as well. Let me just click it into place. There we go. So it's in place, and it also folds up to the device as well. Now let's set this up like this, and we'll set it up. So now we'll go ahead and set everything up. We'll hit yes.
Hi there. I'm Cortana, and I'm here to help. A little sign-in here. here, a touch of Wi-Fi there, and we'll have your PC ready for all you plan to do. Use your voice or the keyboard along the way, and if you'd like me to stay quiet, just select the little microphone icon towards the bottom of your screen. If you need an assistive screen reader, press the Windows, Control, and Enter keys at the same time to turn on Narrator. Okay, enough intro. Let's dig in. Your region is set to the United States. Is that right?
Yes.
Your keyboard is set to US. Want to stick with that?
Yes.
Do you also type with another keyboard layout?
No.
Sit back and relax while we work our magic.
Now, while we wait for this, one thing that is the same as last year is the layout. You've got your speakers on the top here as well, and your keyboard, and it looks the same no matter what device you're on. And that's because the front is the same as last year. Only the back has changed on the magnesium chassis.
Next up, the legal stuff. In short, you'll need to select accept to use Windows. You can decline, but then, you know, no Windows.
So it looks like we can't use our voice for this part, so I'll just go ahead and hit accept.
Type your email address or phone number, then follow the instructions to sign in. I'll catch up with you once that's done.
So I'll go ahead and sign in with my account.
Use Windows Hello to unlock your PC, quick as a wink, with just your face. No wink required. Want to set that up now?
Yes.
Okay, hold still for a second. We need to learn to recognize you. Want to set up a PIN?
Yes. So I'll go ahead and create my PIN.
Files and photos to OneDrive for some added peace of mind?
Yes.
Hey, look, that's me, Cortana. Can I have permission to use the info I need to do my best work?
Yes. And you can change those settings later.
These are the settings Microsoft recommends. Go ahead and review them and select accept when you're ready.
So we'll accept. I'm familiar with all of these, and we should be just about done.
Almost done now. We just need to get a few more things polished up for you, and Windows will be all yours. Looking forward to helping out.
We're up and running now, and this is what it looks like as soon as you boot it up. Not really anything exciting, although it is a pretty nice wallpaper here. Now let me connect this, and it changed by itself. That's what I had set prior to that. Let me see if I can open this up. Here's the pen itself, just like any of the other pens. We'll remove the cover here. It looks like I shredded that, but let's remove this. Now the pen is unwrapped and it should be pretty simple to pair. Now you can pair it for more features using this button, but it will work right away on the display. It also sticks to the side, of course, and we're good to go there. Now as far as the overall use of this machine, it should be up to 60% faster, and it also has up to about 12 to 13 hours of battery if you're just watching video. So it should be pretty good that way. And if we close it, it looks really good in black. And I like the way this Alcantara kind of sets off the two-tone look of it. And you may or may not like it, but I like the Alcantara better than the plasticky feel of the other one. Now, of course, we have this vent here for cooling, and that's it. So no fans. It should be nice and quiet. This probably looks like it's going to be a fingerprint magnet, but other than that, it looks really nice. And based on what everyone's saying, it's really fast, and it's just a major upgrade as far as internals, but other than that, it's the same thing. So let me know if you want to see a full review on this, anything specific you'd like to know about it that maybe you're not seeing elsewhere. I'd be happy to do that, just like I did with the Surface Go, maybe some applications that you're wondering about if they'll work well. And we should have Windows Hello here, and it recognized me immediately, and we're good to go. So that's it. It looks pretty good. I'll get updating it. I'll see if it'll play some video games maybe and go from there. If you have any other questions or comments, let me know in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.